So welcome to OWF 13. We're here with Stefano Maffoli, the community manager of OpenStack. Welcome, Stefano.
Thank you.
We're glad to have you here with us today.
Good to be here.
So OpenStack, could you give us just a brief intro to what the project is and your involvement as a community manager with
the
project?
Sure. OpenStack is a project that was started 3 years ago, a little bit over 3 years ago, by Rackspace and NASA. They had a common interest in developing something that would allow for infrastructure as a service, software that can be used to create clouds, basically. You call with an API, you make a call, and you have virtual machines, virtual storage, and virtualized networking. These are the three basic pillars upon which OpenStack is built: virtual compute, virtual networks, and virtual storage. And so the software has been growing since the announcement in July 2010 by these two companies. It's been growing very rapidly in the past years.
Okay, so where is OpenStack today? So in terms of size, community, and everything?
OpenStack right now is probably the fastest growing open source project that I've ever seen, and I've been in open source for over 10 years. So right now, the last time I checked, there were over 1,000 developers touching the code from 68 companies. And aside from that, there is a very large ecosystem around OpenStack. The foundation, the OpenStack Foundation, which was founded in November 2012, is participated by over 200 companies. So there is a large ecosystem around it of companies that are not only developing OpenStack, but they're building products and services on top of it, enlarging it, building plugins, and bundling hardware and software together, building services on top of it. So it's a very large and huge ecosystem and community growing.
So, and I think there's an upcoming release right in the corner. So could you tell us a bit more about
that?
We're
very excited. We have a very very precise and very predictable schedules. Every 6 months we create a new release. And the new release is coming in the middle of October. We have done a lot of investments in the past year, or so in the past two releases, to make sure that OpenStack would be easy to deploy, and not just adding features every time. So right now the project is becoming stable enough that we keep adding features, but we also focus on making sure that all the companies that are already using OpenStack, that have built public clouds or private clouds for their internal purposes, they can keep maintained, they can upgrade without having to go through major hurdles. And so the new release is coming up in the middle of October. We will have a bunch of new features, especially in the networking world, the project is codenamed Neutron, but its official name is OpenStack Networking. The OpenStack Networking will have a lot of new plugins, a lot of new integration points, a lot of improvements also being made to the full open source stack of it. So it will be a lot more easy to deploy, but also there will be a lot more features in the networking world. But also there are a lot of new features in core projects, the compute and the storage parts, block storage and object storage. And we'll also have new things coming up in the orchestration layer, the orchestration layer connected to the reporting and the metering layer. So things would be more easy. Something like when something happens, there is an alarm or some resources that are becoming stressed or scarce, something else automatically can happen. So all those scalability issues that infrastructure as a service is designed to solve will be much more easy to be done by the developers.
And aside from that, you also have a summit coming up very soon, right?
Absolutely. So here's all aside from our predictable release schedules, there is another thing that is predictable, and it's the OpenStack Summit. Right after each release, we take a breath, we relax a little bit for a week, and pat on our shoulders, partying. But right after that, we're ready to start planning for the next release cycle. And since we have a huge community of developers, what we do is to bring them all together into one place, into one room, and decide together what the roadmap for the next 6 months will be. What feature they want to work on, what are the what are the plans, what are their ideas, and they can discuss in person.
Do you already know at this point a bit like what is next for OpenStack in the next 6 months?
We have a rough idea where companies and when people want the project to be, but they will still need to negotiate that with the project leaders. So what happens is that we have a very open and meritocratic community. The leaders are elected by the developers themselves, and when they meet, they will meet in November 4 to 8. In Hong Kong. When they meet in Hong Kong, they will have the new leaders elected, and they will negotiate with them what the path is for the next releases. They will set the roadmap, and they will have blueprints and all of that. And in Hong Kong, at the same time, while the developers are discussing in one room, the ecosystem is also meeting in a more general summit, in a more general conference space. And they will see what has happened in the past 6 months, what are the new features, what are the new products. They will meet users, they will meet developers, they will meet with consumers in the sense of companies that are using the OpenStack APIs to develop new product, new software. It's a huge event, and every time we have it, we have a lot of interesting discussions, a lot of people joining. We had the past one was 6 months ago in Portland, and we have around 3,000 people joining it. So we will expect another huge meeting in Hong Kong in November.
Well, exciting times ahead for OpenStack.
Definitely.
So, well, thank you very much for being with us and for giving us all this information.
Thank you for your time.
And the best of luck with everything.
Thank you. So hope to see you in Hong Kong.
Thank you.